This El Paso History TV program is underwritten in part by the Hunt Family Foundation, an El Paso charitable trust that supports our local community, with the support of the City of El Paso's Museums and Cultural Affairs Department, and by the Pioneer Association of El Paso, Texas.
One of the major battles of the Mexican Revolution took place right across the Rio Grande River from El Paso, Texas, in Juarez, Mexico. And from the 10th floor of the old Paso del Norte Hotel, reporters and observers watched as thousands of rounds of cannon and small arms took place in the Battle of Juarez.
Although it seemed that Mexicans tried to shoot at only each other, enough stray rounds like the 50 caliber rifles could easily fly across the river and hit these observers.
During the Battle of Juarez, schools in El Paso sent children home and warned parents to only let them play on the side of the house away from Juarez. The battle sounds must have echoed loudly across El Paso.
Pancho Villa first attacked Juarez with his troops on May 8, 1911. And 3 days later, Juarez was declared the provincial capital of Mexico. Some rounds did hit people on the ground in San Jacinto Park, and most El Pasoans learned to take cover at these times. 6 El Pasoans were killed and 15 wounded by bullets falling into the city.
During the Mexican Revolution, Juarez changed hands several times, including one significant battle in June of 1919 when the U.S. Army artillery fired from right here on Pill Hill on the Juarez racetrack.
El Paso was directly involved in the Mexican Revolution, with local businesses supplying weapons, uniforms, and other military provisions to Pancho Villa and other Mexican officials. Many of the Mexican Revolution campaigns were planned in downtown El Paso offices in the Caples Building. Across the street, the popular department store sold uniforms to several sides in the Mexican Revolution. As the shooting started, National War correspondents and soldiers of fortune showed up in El Paso by the dozens. Many stayed at the Sheldon Hotel in the 1910s. It later burned down and was replaced by the Hilton Plaza Hotel, which opened in 1930. Pancho Villa took refuge in El Paso years after the First Battle of Juarez. He lived in Sunset Heights and worked at ASARCO for a while. Villa rejoined the Revolution, and in March 1916, his forces raided Columbus, New Mexico. Fort Bliss General John Pershing and U.S. Army troops chased Villa in Mexico, but never caught him.
Pancho Villa left the El Paso area towards the end of the Mexican Revolution, but some people contend it continued for a few more years, with Pancho Villa himself being assassinated by gunmen near his home in Parral, Mexico in 1923. I'm Bernie Sargent for El Paso History TV on ABC7.
This El Paso History TV program is underwritten in part by the Hunt Family Foundation, an El Paso charitable trust that supports our local community, with the support of the City of El Paso's Museums and Cultural Affairs Department, and by the Pioneer Association of El Paso, Texas.